Thank you. Okay, just to start, I would like to present Airbus Group as the company, okay, because maybe most of you are aware about the Airbus as the commercial brand that we use to for the commercial aviation. But we have three different divisions. We have the commercial one when we develop and manufacture the commercial aircrafts. We have the helicopters division when we also develop and manufacture helicopters for civil and military aircrafts, military world. And we have the defense and space division where me and Francisca belongs, where we have different business. One of them is related with the military aircraft design and manufacture. But also we have another business like communications and surveillance intelligence and the UAVs. So you can imagine the big company we are. So just to show a vision of what we have in defense and space about the future of the military aircraft, just let me show a video of what can be the vision of the future on this world. Okay. Okay, so you have seen, we imagine the future as a big number of aircraft flying connected and using big data and data as the new oil for giving value to our customers. So we belong to Flight Test. Flight Test is the organization responsible to perform the flight test and to develop the development flight test and the certification test. Flight Test is not a new business. It's something that we have done from the beginning. You can see in the picture that the Wright brothers just did the first flight test, probably with no big data, because at the moment didn't exist, but with the data that they could have in that moment. So just very few information, probably no computers needed to perform this test, and using the methodology of try and error, okay? But the things has changed, and we have evolved. Aircrafts has evolved a lot. They are able to report a lot of information coming from the avionics data bases, also for the instrumentation of the sensors. And we are able also to follow up the flight test by telemetry means. So let me show you another short video just to explain what is our business, just to centralize the topic in the flight test. Okay, so this video is from the telemetry center in Toulouse. We have in Spain, we have two more. We have one in Madrid, in Getafe, and the other one is located in Seville. As you can see in this slide, what we want to say to you is that we collect a big amount of data, okay? Since the beginning, the data has grown a lot. And today we are in 2018 close to a store by flight close to the 200 gigabytes per flight. Also, we have also more capability to record data. New engines are able to record a lot of different parameters with high frequency. So you can imagine that the big data is something that we have in our daily basics. And what we have to face today in the flight test business is how to adopt the big data technologies in the flight test business. So this is a summary of the data that we manage today in the flight test center for Spain. We store close to 4 petabytes of information. This information is raw data. That means that it's not completely readable by the user, by the analyst. The data has to be converted to engineering values. That means that if we do this conversion, we could multiply by 10 the factor of the volume of data. Another characteristic that we have in this business is that we record almost everything in time series. So time series is something essential in our business. And we manage to instrument sensors at a very high frequency that in some cases can exceed the 10,000 Earth. So you can imagine that not only machine learning techniques are needed, but also machine learning with frequency analysis are needed in this business. Just to focus in some program like the A400M, we made some time ago a calculation of the number of points that we could collect in a database, and the number is almost not affordable by the standard database. So, as I said before, time series is essential for us. We need to take this time series and to offer to the user in the most efficient way. So, this is the reason because databases for us is one of the key components in our architecture, and we have defined a set of requirements that are needed to cover this business. The first one is we need scalability. That means that just with a single node, probably we will not be able to serve this amount of data. We need the integration with other ecosystems like Azure, like Difficult Spotfire, or other tools that we are being using by the analysts. Also, something essential is the disk usage. That means that I will explain later, but because some constraints, we need to store it, to storage the information on premises. Another difference between the IoT world is that normally we perform a flight test. We record the information in a media. We process the data, and this data is just for reading. Normally, the data coming from a flight test is never is going to be modified. Probably enriched by more information, but never modified. This means that we use a paradigm more close to the write once and read many that the IoT world can use. And the other characteristic is even we have a time series, we have other information, for example, the flight report, information that is not well structured. So for that purpose, we are looking for databases that can cover the three walls. The relational standard one, the NoSQL, and the time series in one solution. And the last essential requirement is to have performance. Performance means that today we are based in home solutions. We are happy with these solutions, and these solutions are very good in performance. So if we go to a big database, we have to take into account this feature. Okay? So in that slide, I saw some databases that we are evaluating. Some of them has some of requirements covered, some of them not. I'm not going to enter in details, but just to give to the audience what we are doing in the world of the database analysis. The other characteristics, we are in the defense business. Defense business has some special constraints. I have divided in three, okay? We have, first of all, we have export control regulations that implies that some equipment, some systems that we have to develop are under these regulations that implies that we cannot give information to the specific nations or bodies. The other is the intellectual property. Again, we have to protect the intellectual property of our products. And the last one is the privacy that maybe is common with the rest of the business, when also we have to take care about the protection of the individual data. That means that when we go to the Airbus world, because we have different activities, we have gone to different solutions. That means, for example, at the Airbus group level, the platform that has been chosen is based on Amazon services. But if we go to a defense business, because we are not allowed to send the data outside of premises, we have to build our own solutions. That means that the company has analyzed the different alternatives, and what we have found is that the big data cloud solutions are not covering our requirements. So today, the company at defense and space level has decided to build a digital platform based on a Azure stack and a premises infrastructure. This is the current solution we have. Okay, just to explain a bit, we record the information for the aircraft. We store it in what we call the primary storage. We store in raw data. And we do a data processing where we convert this primary data to a proprietary format that is very efficient if we have taken into account that we are managing time series. We have another protocol that is also developed in-house that is called Data Server that is the responsible to serve to the next layer the data to the analysis tools. And the analysis tool has a connector to this service to read the data and also to feed new data to this to the primary data storage. On top of that, what we have in the right side is the dataset world, where we can connect to the NoSQL databases, SQL databases, some specific exportation for the design offices, and so on. And on the top of the right, what we have is the different tools that we have developed for the analysis. No? So as you can see, most of the tools have been developed by ourselves. We are happy with this solution because this solution is very efficient. To be very efficient implies that we can analyze in a very fast way the different flight tests. And at the end, we can deliver a product sooner with this solution. But what we are looking here is why not to adopt some big data technologies that we consider that are enough mature in this architecture to integrate in a new, more efficient paradigm. No? So we have decided to develop a platform that tries to combine our in-service tools with the new platform. As I mentioned, because Azure Stack is just the solution that the big companies can provide us, we have decided to evaluate the Azure Stack. So the proof of concept that we are doing today is to get the batch processing activities that we are doing in our in-service architecture and to integrate in the Azure Stack environment. This will produce some advantages, for example, to give an abstraction layer to the user. The user will not need to know where it's executing some batch. Also, we will offer a more efficient computational platform. So the idea is to offer a next layer for the user just to avoid the hurdles that they have when they have to execute the batch processing in some computers. No? What happened? Azure Stack is a very new platform. As you may know, the Azure Stack is sold as a hybrid platform. And what we have found is that some essential services, or at least the services that we consider essentials, are not still migrated to the private platform. So, for example, Azure Batch Services, that is one of the key services that we would like to use, is not still migrated to the Azure Stack. It's just we can use, but we have to go to the cloud solution. No? So this is more or less what we are trying to do. Okay. Again, we want to combine our existing solution with the new paradigm of big data. But again, we are in the phase to test, to evaluate, and to see what can be adopted and what not. Okay. Just to finish my speech, later Francisca will show us some use cases that we are developing in flight test. I would like to summarize the takeaways. The first one is that flight test is one of the customer where more data we are collecting. Okay. For us, it's very, very important to manage in the efficient way the time series. Time series is essential for us. Not only time series, but also to manage time series in some domains, like the machine learning and also the frequency domain. The second is we have some constraints because our business, where we are not allowed to use a cloud solution, so we have to develop our own solutions. And the big data solution, up to now, doesn't cover very well this need. And the last thing is we cannot start nothing from scratch. We have to look for the integration of our in-service tools. We are happy with them, but we know that if we go to a big data generic solution, probably we will take advantage of this solution, and additionally, we will increase the efficiency. So now I'm going to give the word to Francisca that will explain what BMAT is.
Okay, thank you. I will talk about BMAT. BMAT means Big Data Maneuver Automatic Detection. In flight testing, maneuvers are motion of the aircraft done by the pilot to determine the performance of the aircraft. So a flight is composed by maneuvers. And The objective of this project is to classify and identify automatically all the maneuvers of the flight. Okay. All the maneuvers of Airbus Defence and Space aircraft fleet. Maneuvers are, for example, takeoff, landing, climbing. Okay. So BIMAT is a big data oriented project which aims to automatize the most of the flight test analysis process. And as I said before, the first step is to identify and classify all the maneuvers of our fleet of aircraft. So the maneuvers are determined with a timer slice on initial and final time, and a particular calculation associated to each maneuver. As to know, these timer slices are selected using interactive tools, and even in some cases, are not stored in a database. So we are thinking about to select these time analysis automatically. Are some maneuvers like takeoff, landing, that can easily be identified this time analysis using rules. But there are other kind of maneuvers that we need to use patterns for this identification. Once we have these time analysis, we have in-house software for perform this automatic calculation. The name is JA processor. And this process covers data acquisition, automatic maneuver detection, calculates automatics, and store all in a NoSQL database. And finally, to export all the information using a web service. Why do we use a NoSQL database instead of relational database? Because we want to have the same structure of database of table for all the aircraft, for all the maneuvers. And this information is not structured. So, for example, in air refueling contact, is necessary to calculate to store the time, the duration of the contact or the fuel transferred. But perhaps this information may not sense, for example, for other kind of maneuver like aerial delivery maneuvers. So this kind of calculation, this kind of information can be easily stored in a JSON and finally import in a NoSQL database. And finally, we have all this information, information related to the maneuvers, information related to the flight, in together NoSQL database and relational database. We finally exploit all the information in the web service. This is the process, the workflow of the BIMAP. First, we access to the data using data servers. And automatically, we identify the initial and final time of each maneuvers using rules. We have for this kind of maneuvers in-house software named J Inbet Detector. And for the other maneuvers, we have we use wavelets. And explain later what wavelets is. But I suppose that you know this. And the second step is to perform all the calculations automatically and store all in a database with all the information of the flight, flight report, the objective of the flight, video. So, and finally, we can access to all the information in a web service and even to service video using streaming, okay? So This is very ambitious project that is not finished. We are working on it. In line of big data, we have multiples, maneuvers, different flight, different prototypes, and the solution is parallel processing for all the calculus, multiples matching working together for the same job, and using a lot of matching, we improve the speed of the calculus, and using queue, we can to minimize the idle times. What the technology? We have tested different technology to identify this kind of maneuver that need a pattern to be identified. So we began to use to test a short time Fourier transform, but this only work in frequency domain, and for this kind is not good enough. Okay. And we test neural networks, but our experience was not good, and we need a lot of time to train the net. And finally, we were tested a continuous wave-based transform. It's similar to the Fourier transform, but instead of sine or cosine, we are using waveless model. So what is a wavelet? Wavelet is a mathematical function with some characteristics like zero average, is centered in the origin, and let's be a series of translation and dilatation of a wavelet named wavelet model. The continuous wavelet transform is of a function, is the integral of a function by this family of wavelets. And similar to the Fourier transform, we obtain a spectrogram. In this case, we obtain a scalogram. And it's very easy to find a pattern in the time of we are looking for. And this, I will show you some slides correspond to the steps that we are using to identify the maneuvers. First, in this example, we have a theoretical signal composed by sense. And we select this is, for us, our pattern. And we find the best wavelet that adapt to this pattern. And finally, using the scalogram, we find the pattern in the time history. You can see in the red points are the center of the maneuvers. And this is where the correlation between the signal and the wavelet, the pattern, is bigger. And the scale, the ice axis, we have the scale. That's mean where, for example, as I said in the beginning, we select the first scene as a pattern. And the scale, in this case, the value is 1. And in this way, you can determine the timeline, the initial timeline of this maneuver to scaling for the value of the is ace. So and this slice is to apply this technique in a real flight corresponding to our aircraft C295. This maneuver is a typical maneuver of longitudinal stability. The name is side slip. And you can see in this picture, the aircraft is the time history. correspond to the rudder. The rudder is a surface controller diecast that is located in the tail, on the tail of diecast. And this maneuver corresponds to the, they are moving the, rotate the rudder and maintain in the position like using steps, as you see. And you can see the picture, the calf is sleeping in this way. Is this? You're doing this, okay? It's a typical maneuver. So we select, for example, in this time history, what will be our pattern. The second step, we find the wavelength model that best adapt to this pattern. And finally, we find all the these maneuvers into the flight. And in this video, you can see how the wildlife works. Finally, it's moving around the scalogram. And when find the best correlation, stop and begin to scale the wavelength model until you have the best identification. And in this way, we can find automatically the time lapse of the maneuvers. And we have a database containing not all the maneuvers, because we now are working on it, but we have a database with the characteristic of each maneuver or this wavelength that we use, and we take all the aircraft, all the flights, and we pass for all the wavelengths, and in this way we classify our maneuvers and began the calculus of the automatic calculus that you have to do with the maneuvers. Okay. And that's all. Thank you.
So, if you have any question? If you don't have, we have a last slide. It's not mine, it's from the Human Resources Department that has told me that here in this room there are very clever people and very people interested in big data. So just to say that we are here, we have some open position, not in flight test, but in general in the company. We are in a big company, so there are a lot of departments and a lot of business where big data is key. So you can see in the slide that entering in the website, you can access to these job positions. For me, are a very interesting company where you could work. And of course, big data is one of the strategic topics in our business. So I invite you to enter in the web and to look for more information. Thank you.